Welcome to Grab and Go Info. One-to-one matching on confounders takes a sample in the treatment group and finds a similar sample in the non-treatment group based on the confounder similarities. The goal of matching is to create a synthetic control group that is comparable to the treatment group. In this tutorial, we will talk about how to do one-to-one matching on confounders using the Python causal inference package. You will learn how to do one-to-one matching on confounders, how to adjust the bias in one-to-one confounder matching, how to expand one-to-one matching to one-to-many matching. Let's get started. In step 1, we will install and import libraries. Firstly, let's install DAOI for dataset creation and causal inference for confounders matching. After the installation is completed, we can import the libraries. The datasets is imported from DAOI for dataset creation. Pandas and NumPy are imported for data processing. Causal model is imported from the causal inference package for confounders matching. To get the code for this tutorial, please check out my blog post on medium.com. I will put the link in the video description. Medium.com is one of the most referenced websites for data scientists. It charges $5 per month for full access. I have been a Medium.com member for many years, and that's the best $5 I spent every month. If you would like to support me to keep providing free content, please use the link in the video description to join the Medium membership at no additional cost. If you prefer not to join, you can still read the post because there are a couple of free monthly posts for everyone to read. Okay, let's continue. In step 2, we will create a synthetic dataset for the causal inference. Firstly, we set a random seed using np.random.seed to make the dataset reproducible. Then a dataset with the true causal impact of 10, 4 confounders, 10,000 samples, a binary treatment variable, and a continuous outcome variable is created. After that, we created a data frame for the data. In the data frame, the columns W0, W1, W2, and W3 are the 4 confounders, V0 is the treatment indicator, and Y is the outcome. Next, let's rename V0 to treatment, rename Y to outcome, and convert the Boolean values to 0 and 1. In step 3, we will initiate causal model and print the raw data summary statistics. Causal model takes 3 arguments. Y is the observed outcome. D is the treatment indicator. X is the covariates matrix. Causal model takes arrays as inputs, so dot values are used when reading the data. Causal.summaryStats prints out the raw summary statistics. The output shows that there are 2,269 units in the control group and 7,731 units in the treatment group. The average outcome for the treatment group is 13.94, and the average outcome for the control group is -2.191. So the raw difference between the treatment and the control group is 16.132, which is much higher than the actual treatment effect of 10. NORDIF is the standardized mean difference for covariates between the treatment group and the control group. Standardized mean differences greater than 0.1 means that the data is imbalanced between the treatment and the control group. We can see that most of the covariates have SMD greater than 0.1. In step 4, we will implement the basic matching estimator on confounders. Confounders matching usually involve the following steps. Step 1, compute the distance between the units in the treatment group and the control group using the confounders. The units with similar covariates produce smaller distances. Step 2, match subjects in the treatment and control groups using the shortest distance. There are different measures of distance. The Python package causal inference uses the inverse variance matrix as the weighting matrix to standardize the covariates, but this weighting matrix can be changed as a hyperparameter. Step 3, estimate the unit level treatment effect for each matched pair. Step 4, calculate the overall treatment effect by averaging the unit level treatment effects. We do not need to manually implement the steps. In Python causal inference, causal.est via matching does the one-to-one matching on confounders automatically, and causal.estimates gives us the estimation results. From the treatment effect estimation results, we can see that the average treatment effect, the average treatment effect on the control, and the average treatment effect on the treated are all around 12, which is a much more accurate estimation than the raw difference of 16. Is it possible to get an estimation that is even closer to the true causal impact of 10? In step 5, we will adjust the bias in the confounder matching for a more accurate treatment effect estimation. Bias exists because the treatment unit and the control unit in the matched pairs do not have exactly the same covariates values. This matching discrepancy caused the bias in unit level treatment effect estimation. To adjust the bias, an ordinary least squares estimation is used to account for the differences in the confounders locally on the matched units. To learn more about the ordinary least squares treatment effect estimation, check out my previous tutorial OLS treatment effects estimation using Python package causal inference. To use the bias-adjusted one-to-one matching on confounders, we can change the hyperparameter value biases to true. From the treatment effect estimation results, we can see that the average treatment effect, the average treatment effect on the control, and the average treatment effect on the treated are all around the true causal impact of 10, which is more accurate than the base version of the confounder matching. In step 6, we will talk about how to use one-to-many matching on confounders. To invoke multiple matching in the Python package causal inference, we can set the hyperparameter value for matches to an integer that is greater than 1. From the treatment effect estimation results, we can see that after applying the 1-to-2 matching, the average treatment effect, the average treatment effect on the control, and the average treatment effect on the treated are all around the true causal impact of 10, which is similar to the results of the 1-to-1 matching. The documentation of Python package causal inference suggests keeping the matches value below 4, although it's not a hard rule. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about causal inference, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.